when you point the finger to someone, you'll get three fingers pointing back at you. But you will have an eternity to be silent, when you'll die. And every death is impartial and terrible. There is not such thing as a good death, that's why it is so fearsome. Therefore, it is better to use your voice, while you are still alive. The worst voice, the worst thought, it is still better than the best silence. And I won't stay silent, in front of the horrible things KDE community does. And whenever and wherever there is horror, there is always Ubuntu. And I'm starting to believe, this is not a coincidence anymore. So, the KDE community, keeps promoting Ubuntu Snap over Flatpak, on their official socials. KDE offers Flatpaks too, and Discover has Flatpak support, but on their Twitter account, we will only see Snap's promos, and not a single reference to Flatpak. Never ever Flatpak, forever Snap. KDE has made their agenda crystal clear, but why this is so awful? First of, Ubuntu Snap is not open source, and second, it has metrics that only benefit Canonical. It is not open source, because the backend that is the actual store, it is proprietary. It is like calling Google Play Store open source, just because APK is an open format, and so we can have stores like F-Droid, Aptoid, etc. And on the top of that, there is also the contributors license agreement. Both these reasons, together with the technical advantage of Flatpak, made Intel to ditch Snap, according to Clear Linux engineers. As a side note, even Facebook is ditching Ubuntu, in favor of OS Tree and Fedora Core OS and Silverblue, according to Facebook presentations on Flock 2019. And then, there are the Snap metrics. I think that metrics can hugely improve open source, especially open source applications, and I'm a big fan to have them on Flatpak too, but only under two conditions. Condition 1, metrics should be optional. We should be able to turn them off. Condition 2 and most important, metrics should be open and publicly available to anyone, with the exact raw numbers, and not just percentages. And Canonical doesn't satisfy these conditions, and neither KDE community. And I don't care about Canonical, but KDE is a community, and it is very sad seeing that from their side. I asked many times why this is happening, and I never got an answer. So I will ask something different. Canonical is already dying, does KDE want to follow?